Everybody out there, my name is Dragnix, and welcome back to Bayonetta 2. In our last episode, we defeated Natu in the City of Genesis, found out that Loki may not be all that he seems, and now we will be going to a remembrance of time and figuring out, getting one step closer to bringing back Jean. So, you'll notice that I have changed up things a tiny bit. You'll notice that the blades on Bayonetta's heels there, that alternate weapon that we got, the Rakashaga, I believe it is called, I put them on the feet at this point under the B equipment to show them off a little bit. Again, you have different weaponry that you can use. Again, though, that's gotta hurt. Alright, so we're gonna be introduced to another character here. A former character.
So, our fates and our paths cross once again.
One for the dramatic. I really would love to have a pair of the glasses in this game. Like, every glasses store that I go to, I wear glasses, prescription glasses. Like, they're all boring to me.
Bingo.
And we have a hero type here that's not very smart, because he's not exactly in between worlds right now, Purgatorio. He's still in the human world. Now, if anybody followed Bayonetta 1, this would be Luca, a reporter who thought Bayonetta had killed his father. He finds out that that isn't the case.
Also known as Diamond Lilies, I think.
Diamond Lilies.
The name Nereid is derived from the Nereids, or Sea Nymphs.
It's really weird how they, in the story, like, it's unsure what goes between worlds and what doesn't. Like, smell seems to go between worlds.
No matter where I am, you always know how to make an entrance. Nice glasses.
Oh,
obviously she's gotten a little bit more respect from him since the first game.
Sake from Japan. It was an easy trade to get him to make these for me. And don't get it twisted, Bayonetta. I'm not stalking you, this time at least. Look, I know you've got nothing but secrets. Hell, that goes for anyone, right?
Stereotypes.
But if there's one thing I've learned in my line of work, it's when I found you, I found the story.
What on earth are you on about this time?
Don't act dumb with me. You know the story better than anyone.
That was a weird transition to the sort of stop panel, or like the almost the comic book style kind of stuff. That's what I was thinking of before. It's a comic book.
To govern light and darkness. But now I know that there really was an overseer. And this overseer is the one who created...
Now, I did read that a lot of people classified, or at least on the Bayonetta wiki, I was reading up on the older game just to be a little bit more in tune with things, that gave him a cowboy kind of personality in Bayonetta 2, and I'm not getting that. Yeah, he looks like he has a cowboy hat, and I'm using air quotes here, but...
God used to live right here in
it's a hat. I don't find anything else cowboy-esque about him.
Realm of the Trinity of Realities.
Yeah, he's a little bit rash, but I don't take that about cowboys. La Porta del Paraiso and La Porta del Inferno.
The real gates of hell.
Is La Porta gates in Spanish?
Listen, I heard about John.
News travels fast in this world, doesn't it?
Uh-huh. Never took you for an animal lover, Bayonetta.
What can I say? I took a liking to one of the locals.
So he's your little tour guide, huh? Look, I know this isn't the time to chat. Let me see what I can find out to help you.
Just don't stick your nose where it doesn't belong, Cheshire.
Don't you worry about my nose. I can smell trouble when I see it. You just take care of yourself.
No, the sad thing is I really relate to Luca's character mostly because I picture myself as him if I was in this world. Meaning good, but not always getting the job done. Or being a complete fool while doing it. Alright, so, first thing we're gonna do is there's actually a Musefaheim portal right here. And if it's the one I remember it is, I'm not gonna like it. Because I think this is one of those challenges that I was having problems with, that I may skip. Oh no, this one's fine. Okay, so I can only deal damage with enemy weapons. Okay, and they throw enemy weapons right on the start here, so... It does give you... You see, again, I love the introduction to things like this because it almost serves like a tutorial for it. Like, okay... Here's some enemy weapons. You may not have gotten them yet, but we're going to give them to you right now. So you can play around with it. And so again, it serves as a secondary objective, but it also serves as a sort of a training exercise. Which, I mean, it's good to mix those kind of things. Gives you incentive to play these. And I got a gold medal, and we got ourselves... a whole moon pearl now, so that will give me more magic to work with. I did learn a little bit more of the fact that, I mean, your strong attacks can use magic. They're a lot more powerful, obviously. It's certain combos that you can do, so that's good to note. You can blow a little bit of power if you need it right away. See, I need... So you notice that like my combos reset for all my foot-related ones because I'm using the blades on my feet now. Which, okay, if she's running, this is like the most impractical pair of heels at this point. So every time she runs, notice how the blades would be embedding themselves into her gluteus maximus. This is the worst designed shoes on the face of the planet. Okay, now, secondly, I do remember that there is a treasure chest over here, and I don't understand why it is so deep into this. Okay, so they made this wonderful underwater portion. I don't know why it needs to be underwater to begin with one treasure chest so far down. Alright, fine. It's a broken witch heart. We can use it. And there's nothing over there, so we're going to go all the way back up. Make our way back up here. What else? Did I miss anything? I don't think I did. We're going to get into a little combat now, because a big circle area means combat. And we're going to be introduced to yet another enemy type. The Enrapture. Another third spear. Third spear is like the lowest tier. So note that. And you notice there I did a power attack. Now, from what I see from the Rakagasa, the blades that I put on my feet, they seem to have some more horizontal range on them. As you notice there, like, I wasn't even, you know, attacking in the general direction of them, but I was able to hit them. But it does seem to have a little bit of a reduction in vertical range. Vertical towards the enemy. So horizontally it's alright, towards the enemy not so much. So... And some bullets in the face there. I'll take that. And... There we go. So, again, it comes down to what kind of playstyle you want. I want to show them off. I like having the bullets on the feet, but this does work as well. And I do want to show some variety off in the weaponry. Again, this is so far I've had an amazing time with this game. Usually when I don't replay levels in games, I'm obviously doing it a little bit more now when I'm doing some of these videos, but... usually I have my one fill and that's it. Here I've played, you know, levels a couple of times just because, you know, first recording, you don't understand what's going on the level, you may not be able to comment as much, so, like, this one's my second playthrough. So, I know a little bit more about the world at this point. So, like, right now, I know that, Loki is waiting at this dock, he's having a little bit of an episode. He's got cards. And now we're gonna go into VHS mode. And by VHS mode, I know this is not real VHS or anything, but that's what I'm calling it.
What's this?
Old grainy film projecting. And who is that? It looks very similar to Loki. And he throws a magic card at it, and look what happens. What did I do? Oh, crap. So now, we're going to go in the witch time here, and we're going to run through what he has created at this point.
Where did you learn that trick, little one? I've never seen a witch, or a sage, for that matter, pull off something like that.
Come on, love. You think I'm just going to tell you my secrets when I don't even know whose side you're on?
I don't think he knows how he did either.
Remembrance of time. That's a big deal here.
The remembrance of time.
I mean, no. I got nothing else to say, love.
The remembrance of time.
Now, she pulls out Janine's witch heart, almost like as a prediction of, oh, right, I have a time. I have time here that I need to deal with. Alright, so we're gonna go through here. Again, there's a pigeon right there. They've gotta mean something. They have to. There's gotta be something to deal with them. Is somebody watching them, or is they mean something with secrets? I don't know. Alright, Path of the Chosen. I guess we're gonna read this. While checking for leads at the town library, I spied an old wall print between dusty volumes. The ancient print depicts the sacred mountain Fibuventer and a long corridor emerging from the summit. This path leads through the Cathedral of Cassades, terminating at a tall tower within the city. If accurate, this print confirms that while the tower is a shadow of its former glory, at one time there was a path from town leading directly to the mountain's peak. Nothing too groundbreaking about that, but the next mural I found was harder to swallow, to say the least. It showed people walking directly up the walls of the aforementioned spire. I thought the seer might have gone to my head. But no matter how I looked at it, the truth was plain to see. There was a perpendicular parade going up that tower. Were these the chosen ones I had heard so much about? Were these the chosen few who could walk the path of the god waiting up top Fibuventer? I cannot pronounce that mountain name for the life of me. Alright, so some interesting color choices there with the purple flowers in the middle. And look, circular area. And actually, this is somewhat of a new enemy type because we haven't really dealt with them a lot, but... Now, one thing I do note is the fact that the torture attacks, they're always the same, like, same button to hit, which... I would like to see it varied, like, you know, for you to react to it more. So, like, you know, choose between A, X, and Y. But, you know, it's a small hit compared to everything else. Come on. Alright, so there... He's down, got some health back from him, that's good. Have a hammer of theirs, and some more cutscene motion. He's got a headache, he needs some aspirin. He's having some issues here. He's being a projector.
If you were gone, it'd all be...
It's really getting hard to follow what's going on with this kid. They're introducing a lot of like mysterious, like, oh god, he may have something, he's something special, with not a lot of guessing or context that can go into it, so it's a little bit hard to keep track of. Alright, so first we're gonna go get that golden LP, because that's gonna mean another weapon for us. William Tell Overture. Alright, we're gonna go stop at the shop for a second, and I'll speed through this as much as I can. Meanwhile, he's going to make a set of stairs. Actually, before we do that, we're going to get that treasure chest that I almost missed again. I actually almost missed this in the first time around, too. So, we're going to go right in here. We're going to enter the gates of hell.
Another LP. No rest for the wicked.
No rest for the wicked.
But no need to pity me. I was bored anyways. Be right back. This one's gonna be fun.
He must have a really weird definition of fun, but then again, he is a demon.
Like this for a while. Ta-ta.
You just gotta work out. I mean, that's why I'm using the blades here. Come on, man.
You know how they say life's a bitch?
I do.
I've been dead for a couple millennia. A demon cranky as shit. Don't think this demon will be complaining anymore.
Alright, Kafka, which seems to be a bow and arrow, and I am partial to bow and arrow weaponry. There's no doubt about that. So, alright, so we're gonna actually... We are going to put... Kafka, in our hands. Now, this can only go on our hands. So you see there, we have a bow and arrow now, and I am partial to bow and arrows, so... It's a little bit slower rate. It probably hits stronger, though. I'm gonna take a guess at that. So... We'll see what comes of this. Okay, so you did that. Is there anything else I need to take a look at here? Probably not. Just jump right through here. And I think this is going to be another battle sequence, because it's a wide open area. Yep, of course. We're going to climax right away. Right into... So we're seeing that it looks like... Oh, ow, 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 that really hurt. Okay, and I screwed that up. I screwed that up royally. We're going to try that again. Alright, so back to this again. So it's seemingly doing a lot of damage, so it's very... damage-oriented. I am taking damage like no other here. Now the thing is, though, what I'm not liking about it is it really just takes my punch away. So, and I mean, it really makes me focus on kicks. Now, that which is sort of sucky at this point, and you know what? I don't like that. Now, it may work good with the Rakakasha, focusing on doing kicks and then only doing that in terms of ranged attacks or anything like that. And in fact, I'm going to change that up now, quickly. Off screen. So that I'll focus on that when I need to. And again, we have another enemy here. This is a familiar enemy. So climax here, we're gonna hit him hard. We did this with Janine last time, but you know, we've grown a little bit. And again, with him, these bigger guys I find to be a lot less problematic because they hit hard, but they telestrate their attacks so well, or much, except for that one. Or actually, he did telestrate that attack pretty well, I just wasn't paying attention enough as I should. I wonder... I'm assuming... I'm not gonna even waste the Urban Climax on it, I don't need to. We're gonna climax here. Right into Princess Frog. It's probably some kind of demon, I don't know what demon it is, but I'm gonna call it the Princess Frog, and it is creepy as hell. My sister would be freaking out right now. Sister is not a fan of frogs. Platinum? Excellent. Alright, so... we have a Musefaheim here, and I think this is the one that I skipped in my first playthrough because it was just that hard. We're gonna show you it, obviously, but I may skip it just because I suck at this. Ah, yes, defeating all enemies using a single combo. Now, I think it's that you don't have to defeat enemies with a single combo, as in only using in one major combo. I think it's the fact that you just use one combo in general. So, obviously, I'm gonna use just the XXXX hitting combo at this point. Because I don't want to mess up by doing one with a kick and not just screwing it up majorly. So, there we go. That was easy. I'm not sure what gave me a problem the first time around. I think I did it because I did it with a foot combo and I kept on messing it up. But I'm not even sure, I don't even remember it really, like, making a difference, but who knows. I will note that there are a significant amount of loading times between the Musefaheim world. Loading sequences. Alright, so I can jump down here. That'll bring me to this door. I don't remember if there's something in that area over there or over there. No. Alright, so we're just gonna go right through this door. And we're gonna be introduced to the end of the chapter. Which seems really short compared to everything else. Now you'll note I missed three sections there. Alright, it'll happen. Not even sure where I missed them, but I did. And we also get a verse card. This is something for the co-op experience. I'm not exactly sure what it is. I haven't attempted to play the co-op, but, you know, I'll try to find some time to do that. So next time on Bayonetta 2, we'll be going to Paradiso, the Gates of Paradise, and making one step closer to defining Jean. And hopefully coming one step closer to finding Jean. And hopefully Loki stops having his episodes. The guy needs crazy pills. See you later.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you have a chance, leave some feedback and comments below. If you liked the video, hit that like button. And if you want more content like this, hit that subscribe button. This is Dragnix signing off, hoping that gaming brings as much fun to you as it does for me.